Sometimes God challenges the puffed up scientific doubter, and this is one of those challenges. God says, if you cannot understand this, how can you question me? Or worse yet, tell others that I don't exist. Hello, I'm Dennis Bank, and welcome to Yadavitz. Actually, it's a Hebrew word. I think it's Yade, that occurs 953 times in the Bible, which means to learn, to discern, to know, and to become wise. You remember the spinning top you played with as a kid? The spinning top resembles the earth spinning on its invisible axis. The top is manufactured to be uniform in size and weight on all sides. Now, what happens if you take a top and fasten a weight to one part of its perimeter? Well, it's now out of balance, and it will wobble and shake, toppling over. Now, if you fasten a second weight as a counterbalance exactly opposite of the first weight, the top will spin again. It is called equilibrium. Another example is balancing a tire. A tire that is out of balance will cause vibration and excessive wear to the vehicle. To compensate for unequal distribution of weight around a tire, a technician fastens small lead weights onto the wheel to balance it so the tire runs smoothly again. It has achieved equilibrium. The same principles apply to Earth. Over the last two centuries, theories were developed, eventually leading to the field of study within geology known as isostasy. Now, isostasy describes automatic weight adjustments to the Earth to maintain equilibrium as the Earth spins on its axis. Now, God doesn't have to show us details of his design for his own sake, but rather for our sake, so that we can put our fickle minds to rest and know that God is and was and is to come. God never asks us to bypass the mind he gave us to believe in him. God expects us to use our brains and sometimes even to stretch them out a little. God, as Isaiah, lay out the principles of isostasy in simple terms 2,500 years before it even crossed the mind of our modern-day scientists. The Bible says, and this was written in 700 B.C., who hath measured the waters in the hollow of his hand and meted or balanced out heaven with a span and comprehended or calculated the dust of the earth in a measure and weighed or compared the mountains and scales and the hills in a balance? Isaiah informs us that to God, this balancing process is an exact science requiring precise calculations and measurements. The topographical placement on the earth is not happenstance, but rather of necessity. It must be weighed out in perfect balance so the earth doesn't vibrate as it rotates, or worse yet, start wobbling back and forth. In fact, 1,500 years before the writings of Isaiah, we have Job giving witness to God's work of weighing the waters of the earth. This is what Job says. To make the weight for the winds, and he weigheth the waters by measure. In other words, God is saying that he balanced out the waters proportionately. So we get that the earth needs to be balanced. And this thing called equilibrium needs to be perfectly maintained. But how does that happen? Back in the day, we used to have water beds, which were vinyl bladders containing about 6 inches of heated water. quite comfortable, actually, if they didn't leak. So when I crawl onto one side of the mattress, I cause a depression under me, and at the same time, there is a deflection of my weight that causes a bulge to develop on the other side of the bed. That is how isostasy functions on Earth to balance out every iceberg, mountain, ocean, and valley. The Earth's crust is flexible or fluid and constantly moves to balance out changes in the Earth's weight. God has developed a line that is about 70 miles below the Earth's surface called the line of compensation. Everything below that line remains fixed, whereas everything above that line is able to flex to deflect changes in the outer crust of the Earth. The line of compensation is described by Job. This line is governed by a law of God. Now, man is really clueless about it, except to name it the line of compensation. It's just been discovered recently. Job says, "Where wast thou when I laid the foundations of the earth? Declare, if thou hast understanding. Who hath laid the measure thereof, if thou knowest? Or who hath stretched the line upon it?" That means the rule of law. The importance of the balance being maintained so precisely is so that the Earth's gravitational pull isn't altered, which would have immediate catastrophic effects on our weather. Or, if the Earth were to be knocked out of balance, the psalmist warns that the Earth would totter or be dislodged from its current smooth, predictable rotation. The Bible says, "Who laid the foundations of the Earth, that it should not be removed?" That means to totter or dislodge. That's forever. The understanding of God's active participation in the function and preservation of Earth is to cause us to walk in reverential fear of Him. The Scripture says, "He holds all things together." The Bible says, "Fear before Him, all the earth. The world also shall be stable." That means to be established and secure. "That it be not moved," which means to totter, to be dislodged. Science refers to this stabilizing factor as gravitational constancy. However, science does not understand how it works. Let me quote this honest man of science. "The gravitational constant is a fundamental quantity of the universe. The gravitational constant, G, was the first great universal constant of physics." Ironically, despite centuries of research, the gravitational constant, the capital letter G, is by a substantial margin the least understood, most difficult to determine, and least precisely known fundamental constant value. The quest for G provides a continuing challenge to the experimental ingenuity of physicists. Without a doubt, the capital letter G referenced here is the consistent God that they are willingly ignorant of. Gravity remains constant, but God has the universe laid out according to divine engineering specifications. He is constant because He is God, and He is still active in holding His creation together. This is what Joel says in the Bible. "Multitudes, multitudes in the valley of decision. For the day of the Lord is near in the valley of decision." Your life is like this coin. You can spend it any way you want, but you can only spend it once. Don't forget to subscribe to the Adibits channel and hit the bell to receive our new broadcasts as they are completed.